What are you hearing about what has happened since this 24-hour warning has ended?
It has ended, and at least so far as the last update, and I spoke just about an hour ago with a doctor inside eastern Aleppo, it has been eerily quiet, but people there are waiting. It was just a month ago that that onslaught, that horrific month-long bombing spree ended. There was a humanitarian pause after a month that saw 500 people die. In 1 week alone, 96 children were killed. I was talking with this doctor. He told me a story of a little four-month-old baby who came in. Her house was hit with a rocket. He treated her small head wound. They sent her back home, and then her house was destroyed by a rocket and she was killed. And this is the type of scene that they are fearful will be playing out once again in the streets of eastern Aleppo. There was that warning that they should leave using humanitarian corridors, but both sides are accusing the other of aiming snipers at people. So essentially, the 250,000 plus people in eastern Aleppo feel that they're trapped. They have been growing food in makeshift gardens to get them through the summer, but now winter is coming. The food is running out. The last UN rations have been handed out. Medicine will run out within the next 2 months, according to this doctor. It is just potentially a horrifying scenario. It's why the United Nations is warning that there could be mass starvation if more food and supplies don't get into the city before this bombing campaign is expected to begin, supported by Russia with a huge flotilla just off the Syrian coast. We've seen in the past, they surround these rebel-held areas like they did in the suburbs of Damascus. They surround with ground troops. They bombard the areas. They don't allow food in. And then they basically tell people that they can either starve or die in bombings, or they put them in buses and force them to leave their homes and go to a different area. Is that going to be the case that unfolds in eastern Aleppo? That's certainly residents' biggest fear right now, Amber.